Alright, a bunch of you guys said you wanted to go check out the Volkswagen rally. So, I guess that's what we're going to do before it rains out today. And then we'll do a little dig log. Let's see, you guys will have to ride in the back of the truck because the front of the truck's full of metal detecting gear. I'll drop the tailgate.
Did you have a good ride? At least you didn't fall off.
Afternoon. So this is the river out here in front of the campground. My house is right over there. And yeah, it's a busy afternoon here with all the Volkswagens. What's this guy doing here?
Comes the rain. Guess it's time for me and this camera to get out of here.
What'd you guys think of that Volkswagen rally? Pretty cool, huh?
Well, for today's dig log, I wanted to talk to you guys about some tiny relics. Now, typically when you watch my videos or other metal detectorist videos, you see us finding large items, you know, belt buckles and artillery shells, and even bullets are relatively large items. These are the type of items that if you have a metal detector and it is on and functioning, you're going to find these type of items. So it doesn't show a great deal of skill to me to see those type of videos. It shows determination, it shows hard work, but not a lot of skill per se. And when I see people find a tiny, tiny relic, I think to myself, that guy really knows his machine and what he's doing. So I wanted to show you a very tiny relic today that I found has a lot of significance to me, not only because I found it while I was metal detecting in my hometown, I was metal detecting with my dad and Bob Milburn, but also because of what this relic symbolizes on a larger scale. But we'll get to that more later. Let's have a look at the relic and how I found it. Now, to tell you about this relic, I had been digging in this field with my dad and Bob. There, it was a bean field. It was cut off, I guess, that they had harvested. And it's all sandy soil there. I was hunting with my Nautilus, and we had found quite a few targets that day. But I got a signal that was a very faint high tone, but it was clear and concise. No matter which way I went over it, it was repeating. And that's something that you want to look for as a metal detectorist, is you want to make sure that that signal is repeatable. If it repeats itself in several directions as you move your coil around, you can feel pretty confident that it's a good target and that you should dig it up. So I had this faint little squeak on my Nautilus. I was hunting with my Nautilus DMC-2BA, one of the best machines ever made. So I had this faint squeak and I dug down. The first scoop, when you're digging in that type of soil, you dig down almost a foot. It's so easy to dig there. And I kept digging, and at about 15 inches, this little tiny button popped out. Now I'm going to put it next to a dime here so you can get a contrast to the actual size of this button and just how tiny it is. I wiped it off, and the first thing I noticed was the bust of George Washington. And I jumped up out of the hole. I ran over to my dad. I said, I've got a George Washington button, which at the time I thought that I had a George Washington inaugural button, and I hadn't learned enough about buttons yet. A Washington inaugural button is high on my list, my bucket list. But Bob Milburn came over and he said, oh no, that's a Jacksonian button. Now, Jacksonian buttons were produced in the very early 1800s, And these were patriotic type buttons. They had busts of political figures and flags and that sort of thing. And I was just astounded. And as you see, the shank is gone on this button, but it is one of my absolute favorite tiny finds. And it symbolizes the patriotism that was going on around the world during that period of history. And it's something I've noticed lately is that patriotism has taken a sharp decline just in my lifetime, my 40 years. Talk more about that in a second. I also want to show you one more relic I thought you guys might like to see from that site and that day, because you guys liked the gold ring the other day. So I wanted to show you this other gold ring I found. And I believe this to be early 1800s, maybe even 1700s. It's gold ring. You can see there was opals at one time in the top of the ring, but I think that the sandy, salty soil there ate those opals up. There's no marking inside the ring except for this tiny hallmark, and I don't know exactly what that means. I've never researched it. Maybe some of you might know. I don't. But I found this at the base of a tree that was surrounded by oyster shells. Now, if you live in a coastal area, that's something you should look for when you're looking for old home sites and that sort of thing, is piles of oyster shells. Oysters were a staple of the diet of coastal communities throughout history, and actually they still are. Everybody loves oysters. So keep your eyes peeled for those oyster piles. You might find some great relics like these. But the point I wanted to get to today was patriotism. I think it's something that's gone from the world these days, not just in America. I've noticed in my 40 years, there's been a sharp decline. When the Olympics used to come on, everybody was cheering for their country. Everybody was into it and patriotic and wearing their flags. And these days, people don't even know the Olympics are on. There was just so much sentiment of patriotism throughout the world. And I don't know what has made it decline. If it's media, the internet, television, have we become desensitized? Do we have a lack of empathy? What's happened? What happened? I don't know. That's just kind of my thought for the day. I think, you know, we all need to find ways to get that sense of togetherness again. And I think we can start small in our communities, like events like this little Volkswagen rally. Go spend time at events in your community. Meet the people in your community. Have some empathy for the people outside of your life. It's so important, and it will grow. If you do it on your community level, it'll go to the state. If you go from that level, it'll go to the country. We just all need to get more empathy in our hearts and become closer together, and maybe we'll have more reason to be patriotic again. All right, that's my thought for the day. I got a ton to do today, so I'm out. See you tomorrow.